Hello, I'm Dr. Reilly, and now we're going to take a look at the urinary system model. Let us start with the kidneys. Here we have the kidneys. On top, we have the adrenal glands. Leading into the kidney, we have the renal artery and the renal vein coming off of the aorta and feeding into the inferior vena cava. Looking at the kidney, we can see the renal pyramids, cortex, medulla, inside is medulla. The tip would be the renal papillae feeding into the minor calyx, the major calyx. The renal pelvis is under here, leading down into the ureter. The ureter attaches to the bladder. This is the bladder, and this is a male. We know it's a male because here we have the prostate gland. These orangey things along the side are the seminal vesicles. This is the ductus deferens. If we open up the bladder, we will see a triangular area. This triangle is known as the trigon. We'll also notice the inside has rugae, very much like the stomach, so that it can distend and contract. And then here is the urethra. Coming out of the bladder is the urethra, and on a male, it's a lot longer than this. So once again, on this side, we have our kidneys, the adrenals, the ureter coming down. So the ureter is the internal one that goes from the kidneys to the bladder. And I guess you can say that the urethra is internal as well, but I think of it as going to the external. Urethra goes out of the body. Whatever it takes for you to remember it.